acción del régimen de legalidad, seguridad, justicia, igualdad, libertad y paz. Que Dios nos dé sabiduría y que la nación nos juzgue. Se abre la sesión.
Fernando Linares Beltranena is serving out his last term in Guatemala's Congress. But before he leaves in December, he has one priority: a bill to update the reconciliation law that ended Guatemala's civil war in 1996.
Esta ley de reconciliación nacional es importante. Trae paz a Guatemala.
He says the bill is meant to bring justice to those who were victimized by left-wing terrorists during the war.
Es nuestro rol como Congreso aprobar leyes para el bienestar del país.
But what it would actually accomplish is something else: amnesty for dozens of military officers convicted of war crimes, and an end to all ongoing investigations into human rights abuses.
If we look back from 96 to present, the amnesty was one-sided. Look at the statistics. We have about 70 military men in jail and only one criminal guerrilla who is in jail who has been convicted.
According to the United Nations, more than 90% of the human rights violations that were committed during the Guatemalan Civil War were committed by state security forces.
I dispute the numbers given by United Nations because they were collected by one-sided groups that were in favor of the terrorist insurgents.
The United Nations were in favor of communist terrorist insurgents.
They adopted the numbers that were collected by organizations that were one-sided.
An estimated 200,000 people died during the decades-long civil war. The majority at the hands of the armed forces in a scorched earth campaign to eradicate a left-wing insurgency. In the last decade, a handful of military officers have been convicted of atrocities that ranged from forced disappearances to genocide. One of them is Francisco Gordillo Martinez, a retired military commander serving out the remainder of his 33-year sentence in a military hospital. He was convicted last year of authorizing the rape and torture of a young communist student. If Linares' push for amnesty succeeds, Gordillo would be freed.
Moriré tranquilo, con mi conciencia tranquila de que soy inocente. Porque yo tengo la seguridad en lo más profundo de que yo nunca di una, ni recibí ni di órdenes de esa naturaleza.
Entonces, que los cargos fueron, que las acusaciones fueron esencialmente fabricadas.
Fabricadas.
Entonces, eso quiere decir que las atrocidades que se dicen haber cometido durante el conflicto interno, las masacres, las violaciones, los desplazamientos, ¿todo eso ocurrió o no ocurrió?
Ocurrió. Sí hubo violencia, sí hubo crímenes, eso no se puede negar.
Entonces, ¿ocurrieron o no ocurrieron atrocidades bajo su comando en el ejército?
Bajo mi comando, que yo le da nunca. No, mire, en una guerra hay actos negativos, fortuitos, coyunturales, pero que yo haya dicho, vayan a hacer un crimen, nunca ante Dios Todopoderoso. Y eso, como le digo, me da a mí una tranquilidad, una seguridad de que soy un hombre de bien.
A mi mamá la mataron en 1990 por hacer una investigación sobre la población desplazada interna.
Lucrecia Hernández Mack was 16 when, in a case unrelated to Gordillo's, her mother Mirna was killed by a military death squad. She's now a surgeon who was just elected to Congress. She'll start her first term in January.
Si esa ley de reconciliación pasa, sería una burla realmente. Justificar las masacres, justificar todos estos crímenes y abrir las puertas para que vuelvan a ocurrir.
For Hernández Mack and her allies, defeating the amnesty bill is part of a larger fight to preserve a basic historical understanding of the Civil War.
En una sociedad en donde los militares siempre han tenido poder, ¿verdad? En donde los militares te pueden reprimir, etc., esos juicios orales son quizá el único espacio en donde tú puedes ver al victimario o al perpetrador en una cancha nivelada, así de tú a tú. Y Ese es el valor de la justicia. O sea, no se trata de mandar, solo esperar que la gente se vaya a la cárcel y se muera ahí. O sea, no es una cuestión de venganza. Es el mejor mecanismo para dar a conocer la verdad. Y es la manera en que la sociedad debiera decir, esto no debe volver a pasar.
Cuando la gente habla de el mirar hacia el futuro, el perdonar, ¿qué opinas de ese discurso?
Aquí nadie ha pedido perdón.
A lot of the victims of these atrocities believe that having these convictions vacated would essentially erase the little bit of justice that has been done since the war ended.
I say to them that what they're following is their own greed, because they have made millions. It's a business. It's big business to prosecute military men because you get compensation from the states.
So you think all of the victims and families that have brought cases against military officers have been motivated purely by financial gain?
Not purely. Greatly. There is also a certain degree of vengeance. There is also a certain degree of resentment.
For now, an injunction from one of Guatemala's highest courts is supposed to be preventing the amnesty bill from moving forward.
Ellos impunemente están tratando de que no se conozca esta iniciativa por el fondo, por su militar fobia, para que se
But Linares and his allies are choosing to ignore that.
Vamos a llegar a más personas y vamos a tener suficientes votos porque lo pide la justicia.